Yep. Finally, I can upload a blank database. On the right-hand side, you can see my script. Here's what we want. When you press this button, you download a blank template, which is the expense, the input interface for purchase transactions. Alright, it generates this expense file here, which is this Excel file. So what's inside the expense file? There are all the column heads, reference, invoice date, invoice number, whatever. All these that you see in the legacy accounting file. Let me switch it back to English. Vendor invoice. This is the Chinese description, and they are here. Reference, invoice, date. All these black stuff are column heads. Treat them as items. Move on. Here we're using Python, not Excel. That's why you see this file. So where does this file come from? It's from this link down here, where you see all these reference, invoice, and invoice date. Instead of download it like this, not very handy, right? Therefore, my app provides a button for you to generate this expense template. There you go. To do this, I create a variable called temp.exp, which stands for temporary expense. I use a function that is based on this URL, the one that I showed you before. It will be converted to a CSV encoded in UTF-8, which is the universal text format. Now you can display Chinese, Japanese, English, whatever. Then we move on to the app. Here you see ST title. Here is the expense. I just type in something to see what we get. It will be different in the final version. Alright, then inside ST.info, you see the type that wraps around my temp expense, where I convert to a CSV with this get template data function from a byte data. This byte data has to be in CSV so that in the download button, which is this red one, can function properly. If you don't convert to CSV, leave it like this, Control S, save, then you'll get an error. So you must add back to CSV. Let me try skipping the index not equal to false, see if it works. I think it should, because it works by default. Yep, it works. Can export the expense file. Just restore the original code. Then in the download button, here you see generate a blank expense file. Just spot a typo. Save it. The typo doesn't matter because it's just text display. As long as the button press works, it's fine. The data here refers to my temp.exp, which is defined here. It has to be a byte data. This one, byte. But I have to convert the bytes into CSV first. Why? Because the file name X, the expense CSV is a CSV. Set the meme type as well. Let's see if it works. Yep. The meme set anyways. Get rid of them. Down here is the upload dialog box. Just another thing. Let me remove it. Control slash. Save it. It's gone now. Only the download button left. Then all the app contents are wrapped around in between the main function, which is what you see on the app. That's huge. Cause as a complete new user, you can download the template, work on it, and then upload it back. Give you back the upload. Once it's done, let me try upload the template download before. Oops, I limit it to CSV. Excel SX, I see. Good, work on that later, so that we can upload later. Alright, that's it. Ciao.